Another important phenomenon SHM is the SHM of free bodies in absence of external forces. We know well that if external forces are zero on a system, then we know that center of mass of a system remains at rest. If initially it was at rest. This was a concept we already studied in the concepts when we were studying system of particles. Now say similar one situation is there in which on a smooth surface two blocks of masses say m1 and m2 are placed and connected by a spring having a constant k. And the whole system is at rest and no external forces acting on it. And if say the two masses are displaced toward each other and released, and we know that these will start moving away from each other due to spring force and they will start oscillating. In this situation, both are oscillating under the influence of a spring force and as no external forces acting, if say this is the central mass of system, it will remain at rest. And say we are required to find the time period of this oscillation. And we can say if the two masses were initially at a separation L, which was the natural length of a spring, the central mass will be located at a distance L1 and L2 from the two masses, where L1 L2 can be directly given by using the central mass formula, which all of you have studied in the topic of system of particles. Here L1 can be given as M2L upon M1 plus M2 and L2 can be written as M1L upon M1 plus M2. Now if L1 and L2 we are having, we can state if central mass will remain at rest, we can divide the spring in two parts for calculation ease. In this situation, we can assume that the spring of force constant K is having two springs K1 and K2 connected in series at center of mass. As this point will not be displaced or will always be at rest, we can assume that this block M2 is oscillating under the influence of a spring having force constant K2 and M1 is oscillating under the influence of a spring having force constant K1. And this K, which is the actual force constant of the whole spring, is the series combination of K1 and K2, it can be considered. And as the lengths of the two parts are given, which we already calculated, we can easily calculate the force constant of springs K1 and K2. Here K can be written as KL by L1, which is KM1 plus M2 divided by M2. Similarly, K2 can be calculated as KL by L2, which is KM1 plus M2 by M1. Now we can directly calculate the time period of oscillation of both the blocks as they are oscillating together. Their time periods would remain same. So it can be directly written as 2 pi root of M1 by K1 or it can also be calculated as 2 pi root of M2 by K2 as obviously as per logic we have discussed the two must be same. You can substitute either of K1 or K2 will get the value of time period of oscillation as 2 pi root of, if we substitute the value of K1 here, it will be M1 M2 by KM1 plus M2. That will be the oscillation period of these two blocks. There is another way also we can handle, like you have studied in the topic of special concepts of physics about the reduced mass, where we have studied if no external forces acting on a system, one body can be considered at rest and another can be considered of mass reduced to its reduced mass and its motion can be observed with respect to the first body. As I told you, this you have studied under the topic of special concepts of physics. So let's discuss it once again. So let's discuss the alternative method analyze the same situation by using concept of a reduced mass, in which we consider one mass to be at rest and analyze the motion of other mass with respect to the first one if no external force is applied in case of translational, rotational or vibrational motion. So, in this situation, as the spring is having a force constant K, if we consider this M1 to be at rest as no external force is acting, we assume that M2 is oscillating with respect to M1 and its mass is changed to mu, where its reduced mass mu can be written as M1 M2 upon M1 plus M2. This we already deduced in the topic of special concepts of physics. Now, if only M2 is oscillating and M1 is kept at rest, time period of oscillation can directly be written as 2 pi root of mu by k. If you substitute the value of mu, the result will be 2 pi root of M1 M2 upon k M1 plus M2. This will be the result we are getting, which we obtained just now by considering the center of mass to be at rest. And we have taken two separate springs in series. Just in the previous slide, we have analyzed it by using that method.